Oh, hey everybody. Studio's a little bit dark right now. Justin Cruz here with the latest on Hurricane Walaka. Thankfully not a system that's going to affect us, but I'm going to now flip the camera and get right into it so that you know what's going on. So the latest 11 o'clock update shows no change in wind strength with Walaka since 5 p.m. So winds are at 130 miles per hour, gusts to 160 miles per hour, moving north at 13 miles per hour and is now 100 miles northwest of Johnston Atoll. And Johnston Atoll is that little tiny speck right there. And so what we're probably going to see is this thing kind of speed up over the next few days as it's picked up and drawn to another storm system to the north of the state. But as long as Walaka is here, we're not going to have our trade winds. And that's why it's going to feel so muggy over the course of the next several days. And before the end of this Facebook video, we're going to talk more about the trade winds, but I wanted to show you something that was pretty cool. I mean, unfortunately, it came very close to Johnston Atoll, very, very close, actually. And Johnston Atoll is a tiny target. I mean, this is it right here. It's a very small island. There's just an airstrip there. The Coast Guard evacuated four people that worked at the fisheries that were doing some research, and you know, they took them out, they yanked them out, so they're safe now. There's nobody on that island pretty much except for, you know, the sea life and the birds and things of that nature. So now the system is moving towards the north, but still a very strong system, thankfully not affecting the Hawaiian Islands, because should this, I mean, it's got a very Iniki like track, and thankfully this thing didn't curve more easterly of the state. Otherwise, we'd be in a very similar situation with Iniki. So we are blessed to be in that position. Again, the track brings it up north, and then eventually it loses its tropical identity and becomes a cold core storm with that moisture moving away. So yeah, you know, look at this track. Isn't that crazy? It's just like Iniki. So what I'm saying is, thankfully, it curved after it passed the islands and not, you know, in this area here. But anytime I see anything like that, I'm just like, wow, definitely very blessed for sure. All right. So the answer to the question, when will the trades return to the islands? That is going to be on Sunday. Okay. I know it's a long time in the future, but what we have is this stalled cold front and a low pressure system. And we have Walaka. So the presence of these two are the reason why we don't have trade winds right now. So both of these have to wash out. This has to lift to the north. Walaka has to lift to the north. Once they both wash out, then high pressure will start to creep on in from the northeast and the east. And that, my friends, is when we'll have our trade winds again. Oh, sorry, I'm trying to flip the camera. That's when we'll have our trade winds again. So hang in there. I know it's humid. I know it's hot, but it's nothing we could do about it right now until the Hawaiian AC comes back on Sunday. Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a great night, and I'll see you tomorrow on our KHON2 newscasts 5, 6, 9, and 10, and of course 24/7 on KHON2.com. Aloha.